Do you guys know what GMOs are? Are genetically modified organisms?
No.
No.
No. No, sorry.
No, I have no clue.
No.
No.
A what?
No, I never heard.
Never heard of it.
Have you ever heard of Monsanto?
Monsanto?
No, I'm not from around here.
No.
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 Sure, it's a corporation.
Yeah, do you know anything about it?
The Monsanto, they make televisions and...
I wish I knew more about what was happening.
Yeah, they're no good, no
good. They're trying to kill us.
I just know some of the agriculture bill.
You wouldn't like what I had to say about
it. Is that like where they were putting bad stuff in the food?
Bad chemical.
It makes the food cheaper, but it kills you.
Well, it's forbidden in France, so I agree with my governor.
Forbidden in France, they're smart over there.
I just don't like the fact that we get fed GMOs on a regular basis and that we don't know about it.
This ain't United States anymore. Everything's about money and corporations making big money and paying everybody off. It's like, what can you do?
Get that shit out of my food.
No, that's what's killing off people more than anything. It's the food, actually. So, like, you get organic food, or if you live on a farm or something, you raise the meat yourself. No, I'm just saying, you know what's going down.
Yeah, you're very aware. And where are you from?
I'm from Vegas.
Vegas, all right. Do you know about GMOs in Monsanto?
Well, I don't know about GMO. However, I have an issue about Monsanto and the way they're producing our food by not producing proper food. It's plastic. It hurts me to know that my grandchildren are being brought up by you will never know the true taste of food, and my great-grandchildren. And as far as I'm concerned, Monsanto.
Fuck Monsanto! Yeah, fuck them! Welcome to Vegas.
Buddy, you're a boy, make a big noise, playing in the street, gonna be a big man someday. You got mud on your face, you big disgrace, kicking your can all over the place, singing, we will rock you.
So good.
We will rock you. Buddy, you're a young man, hard man, shouting in the street, you're gonna take on the world someday. You got blood on your face, a big disgrace, waving your banner all over the place. Somebody better put your bag into your place. We will rock you. Sing it.
So this is a passionate thing. We gotta realize that people are gonna be here.
Yeah.
And I think there's gonna be more people than we
think. I do too. Honestly, at this point in time, I want to plan for 2,000 people.
Starts with groups like this of like-minded individuals who come together for a common cause to make a difference, to make change.
Morelli, and I'm with GMO Free Vegas. So what are we going to do about this now? Well, to begin with, we advocate the labeling of genetically engineered food, or foods with GMOs. Regardless of how you feel about the GMO issue, we can agree that we should at least have a choice of being informed about what we put into our bodies. We won't have a choice until these foods are properly labeled. We must remember who we're fighting in this battle. We are fighting corporations selling us poison, backed by corporations making us poison, and these corporations will only respond to one kind of vote, the vote that we make with our dollars. Recently, Yoplait faced so much criticism over high fructose corn syrup that they removed it from all of their yogurts. Right before and after the March Against Monsanto in May, we saw major corporations like Whole Foods, Target, and Chipotle make major announcements about deciding to label and or phase out GMOs. This is happening because of us, because we will solve this as making demands as consumers first. We at GMO Free Vegas have all talked to so many different people about this issue, and we hear you. We know eating organically is not easy. It's not as cheap as junk food. And personally, the hardest thing for me is the lack of convenience. So we've decided to simplify our fight to something that can reach everybody and take it all a step further. First, we're going to challenge the corporations. In 1965, a major labor dispute between a union called the United Farm Workers and the growers of grapes in California completely exploded. A young Cesar Chavez proposed at a church meeting to support the Filipino farm workers by instituting a boycott of grapes. At its height, this protest of grapes that weren't even poisonous was supported by over 13 million Americans. Guess what? We're going to do better. We're going to beat that. Starting right now, we're going to boycott corn. This is all you have to do, is don't buy corn. Corn on the cob, corn in a can, corn in a mix at a restaurant, any visible kernels of corn. All we are asking for people to do right now is to boycott corn. This is going to be a clear, completely simple message that will definitely get back to its makers. In the late 60s, the Great Boycott was so powerful that the grocery stores and restaurants refused to even stock grapes, which eventually led to the UFW winning their fight, and so will we. Second, we're going to challenge the government. The scariest part of this entire situation is the fact that we pay our hard-earned money to support the executive, judicial, and legislative branches of our government, and they're supposed to protect us from harm. Every part of the system has failed us. On March 26th, a bill dubbed the Monsanto Protection Act was signed right under our noses. When the details came out, our representatives claimed that they didn't read it, they didn't understand it, or they had nothing to say for themselves at all. This Protection Act is set to expire September 30th, and without interception, it's probably going to carry over into renewal because our representatives are paid by these companies to vote against us. We tried signing petitions to repeal it, but the bill wasn't repealed. So this time, we are going to one-up them. We're asking for you to handwrite a letter to your congressman and request to buy your vote back. Include a $1 bill, stick it in an envelope, put a stamp on it, and send it off to your local congressman's office. Since they only understand money and they abide with as little as $1,000 paid by Monsanto, our $1 bills will speak volumes. They can ignore petitions, they can ignore form letters, but they cannot ignore thousands of dollars of bills being sent to their offices. We are calling this our corn and currency revolt. We are simply asking for you not to buy corn and to send a powerful message to your representatives in the only language that they speak, money. Third, we are asking for you to show up. On May 25th, Las Vegas showed up in mass with 3,000 protesters all dressed in red. If you don't live here on October 12th, we're challenging you to beat it. And if you are one of my neighbors, then we're challenging you to double it. Because we won't stand for poison, we won't stand for cronyism, and that is why we march against Monsanto.